Hello and welcome to the sixth of our series of daily devotions in the season of Advent, the 4 weeks leading up to Christmas, when we'll be celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. But at Advent, we also look forward with anticipation to God fulfilling his promise that one day in the future, Jesus will come again. And so Advent is an opportunity to think about how these two great events impact our lives and how we should live in the light of them. And to help us with this, we've been looking at the opening verses in John's Gospel. And we've already seen that John describes Jesus as the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning, that Jesus is eternal, uncreated, and outside of time. We thought about how God made all things through Jesus. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. And then we thought about what it means for Jesus to be described as in him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. But what does John mean when he writes, in him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind? What kind of life is John referring to? Over the past many years, I've encouraged people who are not yet Christians to explore the Christian faith, and particularly look at the person of Jesus Christ. And on a number of occasions, they've said, well, I don't think I'm really interested. My life is good. I'm happily married with a family. I've got a good job and a decent salary. I support a charity. We have lovely holidays, and I'm happy with the way my life is. I don't need Christianity. And I've said to them, well, I'm delighted that your life is good. Praise God for that. But would you be interested if I told you that your life could be even better, that there's another quality of life that's possible, an even better life? John tells us in chapter 10 of his gospel that Jesus said, I have come that you may have life and have it to the full. Another translation puts it like this, I came so that they can have real and eternal life, more and better life than they ever dreamed of. Life is a key theme in John's gospel. It appears 36 times, and whenever it appears, it refers either to physical life or, more often, to spiritual life. Often it's coupled with the adjective eternal to denote the quality and power of the believer's life. This life is embodied in Jesus Christ, who demonstrated perfectly what eternal life is. Christ is the life that is the light of man. In him, God's purpose and power and life are made available to us. When a little baby comes into the world, that baby has physical life. But in that little baby, there's the potential for another kind of life. It's spiritual life. And only Jesus Christ makes that possible. When you think about Jesus being eternal and being eternally alive, there never has been a moment when he didn't exist. And an essential part of his creation is life. He is alive and the source of life. In him was life. Do you remember what Jesus said? I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. A life free from fear, free from guilt, free from loneliness. A life free to experience God's love and to share that love with others. In him was life. And that life was the light of men. Some people have an idea that eternal life only begins when we die and that it then goes on forever. And for anyone whose life is a struggle, the idea that that may continue on and on forever is less than appetizing. But the eternal life that Jesus has made possible is a new quality of life in relationship with him, made possible through his death and resurrection that begins the moment a person turns to God and seeks his forgiveness. Jesus not only gave his life for us, he gives his life, eternal life, right now. I've been reading some of the things that people have said after they've begun to experience living this life in the light of Jesus. One person said, My life has completely changed. I now look at the world through different eyes. I feel love for everyone and an inner peace that I never imagined could exist. Somebody else said, I had been living my life in a dark hole. I was carrying a great weight on my shoulders. That burden has gone, and I am filled with great hope, joy, excitement and love. And all I want to do is to serve Christ in whatever way he chooses. Another said, I feel like I've found love and conquered death in one day. That's the good news of Christmas. That's the good news of Jesus Christ. Let's pray. In him is life, and that life is the light of all mankind. Lord Jesus, we thank you that in you is life, true life, and that life is the light of all mankind. We thank you that in you is life, the abundant, full life that you've created for us to have. And we ask that you would help us to encourage those of our family and friends who don't yet know life in you. Give us boldness to invite them to our Christmas services, for they will hear about the life that you have made available. Help us with that, we pray, in your mighty name. Amen. Enjoy the rest of your day. God bless you.